One can hang on his level.
He's truly a top dog, no doubt about that. The man is known simply as the excellence of execution.
And representing the Hart Foundation from Calgary, Alberta, Canada, weighing in at 235 pounds, Britt the Hitman Hart.
WWE Universe, prepare to be executed excellently.
Five-time United States champion, seven-time world champion. They don't come much better than the Hitman. Here comes Taz.
And representing the Street Profits from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 232 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, Montez Ford.
That right there, they call that the Graves.
Call that something you wish you could do.
Come on, Montez, show them how it's done.
And they call that the gravy. Don't be jealous, Byron. Don't be a hater. Look out in the cheap seats. Montez Ford can get that high with his frog splash. A true marvel to witness.
Corey, you ever meet a team that knows they're good and you kind of can't stand them, but you also respect them? For me, that's the Dirty Dogs.
See, I love a team that knows they're good. These guys are feeling themselves at all times, and that confidence plays a big role in their success. Plus, I'm pretty sure Saxton would kill to have hair like Ziggler.
Or any hair at all, for that matter. Nonetheless, the Dirty Dogs are seeking a victory here this evening.
And if you're a team that wants to learn how to work as one, this should be a match to start.
This is a match to take notes on. As a team, you always have to be on the same page, but in this one, you can expect to see teams on the same sets.
Wasting no motion on the counter. There he is. Can't prepare your face for that.
We have Bret Hart on the defensive.
Oh! Tag made. Double team action.
Competitors digging deep into their well to keep this match going. Caught with that sharp elbow.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
These two teams have gone to war, Cole. Of course they're gonna wind up with a few battle scars.
Was coming.
fix. Nicely done.
Tagged into action.
They don't call Ziggler the show off for no reason. Oh, no, 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 no.
Oh, yes.
At this point,
if this works, it could change the course of the match. He's lining him up.
Perched up top. Blockbuster connects. Able to get the advantage here. Suplex. Such intensity from Ford.
And Ford is bringing the smoke. Pulls their opponent in. Belly to belly.
That's gotta be it. Coming to the rescue. He's heading up top.
Thinking big.
From the top. That one fails to land. Missed the mark.
Double underhook applied.
Butterfly suplex. And Ziggler getting rocked there with one heck of an offensive statement at this point in the match.
This is what the purpose of a tag team is. Don't be afraid to use the resources and help your partner offers. Am I being diplomatic enough, Cole?
All right, that's it.
Puts him up with an earth-shattering spine buster.
That was glorious.
And just like that, he sent crashing to the floor. Stop right there, gut. Rude, he's thinking big.
He's got to know he's in harm's way here.
From way up
high, double axe handle.
Who's got the pump handle?
Uh-oh.
Sudden cutoff from Brett. Just got answered with a suplex.
What a really great swinging neck breaker.
Elbow on the spot. Brett was waiting for it.
And the rolling neck snap.
Robert Roode is full of confidence now, and he's letting the WWE fans know it.
Tag made.
Shot after shot, then slamming their face down.
This match grinded him down a little. Ooh, what a punch.
That's how you stop your opponent.
He turns it around. An elbow will break that up.
Good grief.
Trying their opponent's arm up. Carefully measured double stomp.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
No, that'll break his arm. Vicious. Can Rude withstand much more of this?
Rude needs to find a spot. Savage stomp right to the arm.
Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
That'll turn your lights out.
My goodness, came down like a hammer on that arm.
Oh, man, that'll bend your arm.
Measured kick to the vertebrae.
He's in a bad way, guys.
Yeah, not looking good at all.
Rude can't be feeling glorious right now. Up in into the line. And there's the tag. Dolph Ziggler into the ring.
That was brutal, and now the blood is flowing from Ziggler's face.
Ooh, brutal forearm.
Time in this matchup.
This is a time to dig deep.
Into the corner he goes, a perfectly placed target, and we just saw some serious offense.
Ooh, saw it coming and hit him with a shot to the face.
Finds the advantage after a string of counters.
Goes under the ropes to get back inside.
He can end it here.
He's got him.
Wait. How can that be fair?
Come on, ref. Keep these guys in check.
Turning the tables there.
Able to give him the slip. He saw it coming and took him down. Watch out for Dolph. Sinks it for the win.
Should have been three.
I couldn't agree more.
Ziggler has this in hand. Looking for the victory. There's two. He's the proof. He's got the victory.
Here are your winners, Robert Roode and Dolph Ziggler. Dirty Dogs.
Dolph Ziggler with the finishing touches on this one.
That's about as perfect an example of tag team wrestling you're ever likely to see.
Here comes a reckoning.
The Archer of Infamy, ready to pass judgment.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring, representing the Judgment Day. From New York, New York, weighing in at 249 pounds, the WWE United States Champion, Damian Priest.
No longer cares for the WWE Universe. No longer cares for the rest of the locker room.
Because he has found his true family, and the Judgment Day is their name.
A look of pure disdain on the face of Damian Priest.
Well, it's because he has passed judgment on the entire WWE Universe and has found them all unworthy.
It's all about the money. It's all about high risk. It's Shane O'Mac in the house.
And his opponent from New York City, weighing in at 235 pounds, Shane McMahon.
You are looking at a man who will not back down, no matter what the odds.
Yeah, one of the biggest risk takers in WWE history.
He is preparing to go one-on-one with one of the most destructive forces in WWE, in Damian Priest.
Here's Shane McMahon, as different of a competitor as they come compared to the rest of his family.
Oh yeah, Shane O'Mac is an absolute daredevil. Seemingly can't have a match without putting his body on the line. This is a man who goes for broke every time the bell rings.
And sometimes that strategy pays dividends, while other times, well, it crashes and burns. We'll see soon which outcome Shane will be facing here tonight.
And here we have a man familiar with fighting to the top. Damian Priest spent many years on the independents proving that he had what it takes. Since arriving in WWE, that drive and passion has not softened.
The Archer of Infamy rarely misses his mark, but if he does, his opponent better be ready to seize that moment, because it won't last long.
Oh dear, this doesn't look good.
A perfect mix of pure power and bad intentions.
Placed in the corner. Shane McMahon will stop at nothing to win. How do you overcome a competitor who has no fear?
You wait for Shane to go high risk, and then you get out of the way and let him crash and burn. If Shane O'Mac gives you that opening with his reckless stuntman antics, you'd better take him.
A superstar hook in the arm.
Look at this rush of strikes.
Every ounce of the body is a target.
Not the position you want to be in right now. Snake eyes.
Ooh, what a nasty kick. That's disrespectful.
And it looked like one of those rare openings Priest gives his opponents was capitalized on there.
Yeah, as Shane O'Mac is giving it his all.
Shot to the midsection connects.
There they go. Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the referee's count here.
Stomp in the leg.
Face first with a waistlock takedown. Carefully measured knee drop. To reverse. Has him wrangled. Irish Coast backbreaker.
He may not be aware of the count. He's got to get back in.
Ripcord applied. Oh, and a forearm. He's absorbed some damage already. He's got him scouted.
Still no end in sight here.
He's got him down. Is this it? Getting the shoulder up before two.
He's not even close to being done yet. DDT delivered.
What's Priest in for?
My, down with authority. Shane O'Mac way up high. Top row, measuring his opponent. Priest has him lined up.
We're about to take a self-propelled chokeslam. That could finish off Shane.
Makes the cover. Kick out. I thought he was finished off for sure.
His opponent thought he had it in the bag for sure.
This is when you have to switch game plans. You can't let yourself get discouraged.
That was close, but Damian Priest doesn't look like he's letting that distract him from the task at hand.
Slow him down.
He's going for the pin. This could be it. Into the pin window. On the ropes, referee breaks the count.
Things up. using the elbow to escape the attack.
Superstars' faces. Exhaustion is beginning to set in.
They're starting to breathe heavier. This is the time where matches are won and lost.
Priest with the elevated flatliner.
There's the evidence that Priest's actions are always going to speak louder than his words.
Damian Priest, grip locked in.
South of heaven. Priest ended this fight.
That's gotta be it.
Two. He's still in this fight.
I truly thought it was all over there. Resilience.
Yeah, but did you see how the referee had to get into position? That was all the difference.
Priest clearly thinking, what am I going to have to do to put this one away?
Down. Glam slam. Free fall.
These superstars must be feeding off the WWE Universe.
This place is starting to rock.
Ship here.
A 110 string slam.
And they can't beat the count. Double count out. Well, tonight just became happy.
The following contest is a 3-on-1 handicap match. Introducing first, from Kansas City, weighing in at 275 pounds, Happy Corbin!
Story just pulls my heartstrings. It is great when good things happen to good people.
Good people? You think Happy Corbin's a good person? The amount of people he treats like absolute garbage?
Hey, Corey, did you get the invite?
I sure did.
Really?
We are in the town.
Going out with Corbin.
Graves, hey, happy Corbin.
I never got an invite, guys.
There's a reason for that. Actually, probably a dozen.
These two are all about beating people up and winning gold.
And they have won gold all over the world.
And their opponent, at a combined weight of 505 pounds, Carl Anderson and Luke Gallows, the OC!
Already cemented their legacy as one of the greatest tag teams in the world.
You're right, Cole, and that's why the tag team division has been on notice since their return.
They already look mean. Now they just need the green.
They make short work of their opponents and head right to the pay window.
Here comes an amateur standout and a tag team specialist, Rick Steiner.
His bark is bad and his bite much worse.
And representing the Steiner brothers from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 255 pounds, Rick Steiner.
When it comes to this guy, unpredictable is an understatement. He's like a rabid dog.
Yeah, Rick Steiner lives on that fine line between genius and barbaric.
I think we'll see the barbaric side tonight.
He's got an unorthodox style, but you can't argue with the results.
This handicap match is underway, and the numbers are uneven, as you see. Happy Corbin. And imagine the chest that faces you when you look across the ring and see Carl Anderson, Luke Gallows, and Rick Steiner.
Listen, no one wants to see anybody get hurt here tonight, but when management allows a superstar to have the odds stacked up against them like this, I just can't condone it.
And that's why you don't make decisions around here, Saxton.
Look, lessons have to be learned,
and punishment like this can be very effective in doing so.
Look at this, just stomp after stomp after stomp.
You gotta wonder if there's more animosity in this match than we previously thought.
Oh, I heard a snap.
Crackle, pop. He saw it coming, taking advantage. And Corbin's plans fail there. The damage he's taken is starting to pile up. How's that for a counter? Oh my goodness. Ah, what a, can he score the pin? And he manages to kick out in one.
Still has enough energy for the simple kick out.
Could have a disadvantage?
Absolutely. The handicap's usually there for a reason, and that's because the other side has certain advantages. It's important to remember your strengths and play to them.
Spiked with a uranage. And he throws the opposition back into the ring.
I don't think Corbin's thinking of a joke right now.
Let's go.
He went right into that turnbuckle.
Clothesline in the corner. Corbin fights back.
Brutal boot.
Makes him
From the top, diving shoulder tackle.
And will this be it?
A kick out before three.
He got close there. It could be do or die time.
Tag is registered.
To the gut will break things up. Just a dominant display.
Incredible power slam.
Ooh.
Here comes the double team. What are they gonna do here? The boot of
this has just been an absolute massacre.
Whoa. Oh my goodness. Ah, what a smash.
That is just insulting.
Strike. Ah, flipping the script on him there.
Corbin definitely feeling some kind of way tonight.
And it's set right into the corner.
Smash in the corner.
Clothesline to the back of the neck.
Uh-oh.
He foiled that attempt.
Chokeslam back. He thinks he has it. He keeps his team in the match.
Look at this. Just unloading.
Stop to finish it off. At this juncture, you have to wonder if these superstars can keep up this pace.
They're certainly being taken into the deep waters now.
Spinebuster!
99.
Look out! Corbin is giving no quarter.
All of Rick's arsenal is being restricted.
Needed that badly.
Carl still has to do more to get this fully in his favor. He's taking some good hits. Bad predicament right here.
Ooh, he's playing the trachea.
What the heck?
Look at this. He just tossed the leg.
Rick gets that sent right back to him.
Astounding.
Uh-oh. Able to interrupt the attack.
Gets the tag.
Spinebuster. Cover. Two. And he fights it off.
The fact that these superstars
fans can still be moving at this point is beyond the realm of reality.
Went for something, but got a stiff elbow in the head instead.
Is just vicious.
No, that'll break his arm.
Vicious.
Oh, a nasty stop to finish it off. From the middle rope.
Listen to this place. It's unreal.
The decibel level in here right now is breaking glass. These fans are on fire.
Forward smash! What a clothesline! Ouch!
Oh, you can tell he's feeling it now. This fight is pumping him up.
Toss back into the ring. I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
Stirring back to his feet, but he might not know where he is.
Up high! Uh-oh! And all days!
Being a force from Paul.
Game six from the Lone Wolf.
Anderson is in a very vulnerable position here.
No way! Astounding power!
Incredible. How much more can they endure?
Cover! He keeps his team in the match. Oh, Carl answers back. Double smash!
Sharp elbows to the body, looking to fight his way out. He's burying elbows in the midsection.
Go, go, go. Oh, what a knee lift.
Somebody better check his nose.
Luke Gallows tagged in.
And breaking the count. Wow. He got whipped into that corner. Splash in the corner. Followed up by a tech. Will it be? No, it's not over.
What? What? What do you say? This is amazing.
What a match.
Corbin's pulled in.
It sends him down hard.
Complete dominance.
And Corbin's laid out. Kicks out. Just kicked out.
I can't believe that Corbin was able to get his arm up there. Credit to him. I think he has a little bit more than luck on his side.
A new strategy is needed right about now if that couldn't end things. What energy in the arena tonight. Up top. Diving knee drop. Thanks for coming.
In the days. Corbin was right on target.
Uh-oh. Great reversal.
Tag.
Opponent off the ropes. Oh, big body drop.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
No, let him break his arm.
Vicious. Elbow drop to the knee. And that prevents any offense from coming.
Look at this, just unloading. And a stop to the gut, too.
Nice side headlock applied. Oh, and a right hand for good measure.
Shot after shot, they're slamming their face down.
Drawing dangerously close to a count out here. Partner.
Make way for a ruthless opportunist.
Hey, a true Blackheart.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, weighing in at 201 pounds, Tommaso Ciampa.
A multiple-time NXT champion, and has also held the NXT tag titles.
And more main roster accolades undoubtedly on the way.
You are looking at the future of the Bloodline.
And his opponent from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 250 pounds, Solo Sikoa.
The younger brother of the Usos, but had a far different upbringing.
When Jimmy and Jay were getting their start in WWE, Solo was still getting into fights on the street.
When it comes to the street champion, Solo always puts that title on the line.
One, two,
Say what you want about Tommaso Ciampa's approach to in-ring competition. He's a man of conviction. He truly believes that he and he alone should be the standard bearer of this entire industry.
Nothing wrong with a little self-confidence. Ciampa's been at the top of his game for a long time. He just wants the respect and accolades that he deserves.
Well, he's certainly not afraid to fight for those things with an unwavering focus.
And then, referee in position.
Tried for it early.
Caught with a clothesline.
Solo picture
tagged with a punch. Brilliant countering by both competitors. One thing I love about Tommaso Ciampa is his competitive fire. He wants to win.
Cover here. And fends off the pinfall.
He is too fresh to have been kept down there.
Boom, bicycle knee strike.
On the jaw.
Was mounted with punches. And not, oh, a nasty stop to finish it off.
Uh-oh.
Placed into the corner. Knife-edge chop echoing through the arena.
He's lost some of his wind now.
No need to panic. He's still swinging.
Good grief. That's a chop that'll wake you up.
Sequence of reversals here. Both superstars clearly studied game tape ahead of time.
And he'll leave the ring for this next stretch. Sokoa is going up top.
From the top. Elbow drop.
Oh, it's a piercing elbow.
Victory yet.
I think the
uh-oh, he had it scouted.
And too late.
Right on the counter.
Oof, that knee knocking the wind out of him.
And he sends him into the corner. Boom, right to the chest. Okay. You can pick up your teeth in section 112.
So ruthless.
Carefully measured.
Again?
Another knee drop. He may be in a bad way here.
That sort of hard-hitting offense is what we've come to expect from Ciampa.
Face. Ciampa is ready to reload and get back on the attack after that kick out. Whatever's playing here can't be good.
Oh, man, right to the esophagus.
Shot after shot, then slamming their face down.
Oof.
That's using your head.
Ciampa's face took the brunt of that, and it has busted him open.
Oh, look at the knees.
Burying knees into the body.
Oh, wicked kick to the lower back.
Oh, unloading a big kick to the back. Disheartening situation for the Blackheart.
Solo's really on top of his game right now.
He has to be in his limit now.
At this point, it might be too much for him to recover from, Cole.
Great wherewithal from Ciampa.
There's anything
nothing left in these superstars' bodies.
Yeah, the tank is being emptied tonight.
And, oh, fiery lariat.
And he's out of there in a nick of time. He's heading to the floor, but he can't take his time.
Ciampa isn't worried, and he is letting the crowd know it. For these superstars is echoing throughout this arena right now.
Lives to fight another day.
Punch!
Getting set up for something in the corner. Punch right to the face.
This game's about winning at any and all costs.
This competitor knows exactly what they want to do. Perched on the top rope, here it is!
Superplex! Ciampa gets countered there. Oh, look at the scope slam. What a headbutt, vicious.
Shame there had to be a winner and a loser. And, oh, come on.
Oh, man, his emotions are running very, very high between both athletes. Seth Rollins.
A man who has spent a decade atop WWE with the accolades to prove it.
The following contest is a First Blood match. Making his way to the ring from Davenport, Iowa, weighing in at 217 pounds, Seth freaking Rollins!
He's arrogant, he's abrasive, but he's also really freaking good.
And he has the titles and main events to prove it.
And the WWE Universe serenading Rollins with his battle hymn. Time for Seth freaking Rollins to conduct another masterpiece. The prize fighter.
Kevin Owens is always ready for a fight.
And his opponent from Murrayville, Quebec, Canada, weighing in at 266 pounds, Kevin Owens.
Credit where credit's due. Owens realized his shortcomings and has refocused recently.
Indeed, the prize fighter's back. You gotta be aware of Rollins' mean streak. It's ruthless and long.
Rollins will do whatever it takes to win, and this superstar has got to have the same mindset.
There's the bell, and we're about to witness a lot.
Owens in the middle.
Owens popped up powerbomb.
Owens got all of it.
Senton. I'd have to think that a no disqualification match favors the most.
And now he's looking to lock in this submission.
Exhibiting a crazy amount of strength.
Right now he's looking for anywhere to break out of this. And he does.
And he scores a reversal on Rollins.
Rollins dodges in the nick of time.
There he goes. From the middle rope.
Rollins stomp. Owens is in some serious trouble. Something's about to go either very wrong or very right.
Here we go.
Leaping high.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
Break his arm. Vicious.
Oh, there it is. Good court knee.
He reverses it. Moves outside. What's the plan here?
Oh, no. Come on. Don't use a sledgehammer. Think of the shoulder.
He's looking a little off balance.
He saw that one coming.
Oh, drop kick.
Right on the money.
Impressive counter by KO.
KO with the torture rack applied.
Into the neck breaker.
Tossed into the corner.
Oh, elbow caught him right on the bridge of the nose. Oh, my goodness. There's the thinking pays off. Boom!
He got it. That left sledgehammer can cause some serious damage.
Oh, my gosh!
Any one of these attacks could cause irreparable damage, but I don't think you can come back from this many.
Oh!
sledgehammer and is just daring his opponent to move first.
Oh, God.
We are witnessing a malicious string of attacks right now. He leaves the ring and there's no countouts.
Uh-oh is right.
Package pile driver.
Gotta wonder if that keeps him down or fires him up.
And gets tossed back into the mat.
Oh, the sledgehammer connects.
That'll scramble your insides.
He's in a little bit of trouble now.
Typical crafty offense from Rollins as this match goes on.
Oh, that was coming.
I don't know how Kevin Owens or Seth Rollins is able to move at this point.
Where are these men finding the strength?
Right now, it's about who can come up big in the clutch.
Snake blade!
Well, I think we know what Rollins is thinking now.
Stop! Oh, no. I see blood coming from Owens' head now.
That's it. Calling it by knockout.
Here is your winner, Seth freaking Rollins.
Rollins got the adrenaline rush he needed to overcome the firestorm by Kevin Owens.
This was a grueling battle between two elite superstars. KO fought valiantly, but in the end, Rollins pulled away with the victory in a classic encounter.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 220 pounds, Austin Theory.
This young man is as cocky as the day is long, but he backs it up every night.
This guy has everything going for him. Amazing physique, endless charisma, a surefire future main eventer.
The future has become the now, Cole. Austin Theory is already primed for the main event in WWE. Saxton, get out of the way. You can't be in the selfie.
And his opponent, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 218 pounds, CM Punk.
This is the kind of match the WWE Universe has been dreaming of, and that dream is about to become a reality.
A man who elevates his game every week. He is competing at his highest level yet.
Austin Theory!
And here we have a superstar with a big chip on his shoulder.
He has certainly felt overlooked recently.
Well, he has a chance to change that perception in this matchup.
But let's not forget about Theory, a guy who defines confidence the second he walks from backstage.
There is confidence and there is cockiness, Corey. Pretty sure for as much as Theory has the former, he manages to overcompensate with...
Beautiful takedown into the Achilles lock.
He's got a lock.
All the pressure on the left knee. He's trying to fight it. He's trying to break out and does it.
Of in-ring talent, especially for his age. But Corey
to the cover.
And he gets the shoulder up before two.
A little closer to getting the pinfall there, but this is still anybody's fight.
From the apron.
Oh, God!
Two.
Matt holds back Theory's attack. And nothing for Theory to feel cocky about there.
Oh, with authority!
Cloverleaf applied. This has got to hurt.
Look at the angle. Nasty. Genius strategy here to target that back. Literally everything you do with an injured back hurts.
He's gonna try to put him away once and for all. He's out there in no man's land.
Suicide dive!
That is reckless abandon being shown.
And paying off as well.
And he slides him back to the mat.
He is revving up.
Perfect time to attack when his guard is down.
Side coming. Oh, what a clothesline. This match grinded him down a little. Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly, just disrespectful.
Crafty way to get out of harm there.
Down by the DDT.
Looking to end this.
Theory is bleeding profusely now.
Does Theory have any fight left?
He manages to kick out. What strength.
What? How on earth did Theory manage to kick out of that? I cannot believe, but we...
Oh! Suicide dive! Whatever it takes to win. It's like a heat-seeking missile coming at you.
And the explosion occurring ringside.
He takes control. Brought back into the ring from the floor now.
Whoa!
Oh, no! Crashing hard onto the floor.
Brash decision-making there proved to be extremely detrimental.
Can you recover from such an error? You have to wonder.
And he gets delivered back into the ring.
Theory getting ready. End of the night.
That took some serious endurance, I'll give you that.
And for a silver spoon kid like Theory, you have to think he's getting more frustrated by the second.
Theory showing what it looks like to be on top of the world and on top of your game.
Two! How in the world did he kick out?
Holy moly!
He avoids the damage.
It is unbelievable what these athletes have been putting each other through.
Absolutely.
I'll tell you, I thought the superstar was out of this match, but apparently not. What a comeback. Attack right to the sternum.
Theory in a daze. This might be over.
Quick thinking from Theory.
Quick exchange of counters there.
Turn out the lights. And a series of vicious knee strikes to the body.
From the top rope.
Oh, my God. Looks like he has his finger on the trigger now. Measuring it up one more time.
Brutal knee right to the face.
The heart attack at this point. That's it. The blood and sweat put into this match, well worth it.
Here is your winner, CM Punk.
This is the type of victory where you really have to weigh the costs against the benefits.
This is the product of hard work and in-ring adaptability. He's got all the tools, and he put them to use tonight.